Hey guys, haven't posted a video in a really long time. I think the last video that I posted was probably the Xbox unboxing or something like that. Anyway, I kind of got into another hobby. I do have a car stereo system that I guess I should probably update you guys with, since that's what most of you guys are here for anyway. But my new hobby just happens to be paintball. And I decided I might as well do an unboxing. Now, I have already seen most of the equipment, i.e. this was on the wall. And obviously you can see that in the tank. But I haven't actually gotten to play with this or put it together. And I don't have balls currently, unfortunately. But that being said, this is the beast, a little mini GS. Now, I was torn between this and I guess their bigger brother, which is a little bit less cramped on your hands as far as holding it goes. But for the price difference and for the difference in technology that you get with it, I didn't see a huge amount of beneficial upgrades to it, I guess we'll say, other than maybe the size difference. The manual is pretty basic. Sorry for switching cameras there. But I'm going to have to do some research online before I actually can even think that this is set up properly and I'm not doing dry firing. I have owned paintball guns before. But two-piece barrel. Was a on their wall, like I said, so I got to see it assembled and basically learn as much as I could about it. But the adjustment knobs there for the velocity of the balls, you don't want to go over 200 psi. As far as operating pressure goes, so that's there. There's also a vent, as you can see. And if your gun is too high, if it's over 200 psi, actually 210 psi, as I've read the entire manual now, basically it can damage the internal parts of the gun. I want to come back and actually go over how to do certain maintenance on the gun. I'm going to lube up the bolt before I actually use it for anything, as it's been sitting for an unknown amount of time. As you can see, there are those sensors for the ball feed, so if it doesn't see that there's a ball in there, it will not fire. Obviously, it's an electronic gun. That's part of that system that you saw up there. Trigger's extremely light. It's basically, it feels like a magnet pushing it back, and that actually might be what that little piece is right there. In the kit, you do get, I guess I'm putting it on the wrong side, but you do get a barrel cover, and you get most extra screws, bolts, springs, different sensors in case your sensors in there ever wear out. There is a grease as well. Like I said, I'm going to grease up the bolt before I use it. And there is some soft parts in there as well, and I don't know exactly what that is. I'll have to do some digging online to find out. But all the different seals that you could need, at least one set. So they do set you up quite well as far as maintenance and taking care of their product. The Canadian pricing is a little ridiculous for a lot of this stuff nowadays. Welcome to post-CV pricing. I have a Spire IR2. I heard good things about the IR1. Haven't seen too many reviews on this guy yet. I'm pretty stoked on its operation. It seems to be fairly stout. I saw complaints of the guys hitting them and them popping open, but I haven't had any issues reported from the guys at the store. As you can see, I'm just trying it now because it made me nervous hearing about it online. Single button operation, obviously, on off. Uses double A's or triple A's. I got told about it. I think it has it on the side of the box too. This is what it reports. So it's 9-ball raceway. It's a toothpiece. I don't know what speed ramp is. Optional speed ramp, I don't know what that means. Never jams, never pulses, soft on paint, consistent feeding, durable nylon black shell, Spire IV, 3 and 4 speed feed compatible. So, it's a pretty cool little unit as far as what I've seen from it so far. Taking it apart is interesting. Again, first time doing this, so it says you don't need tools. How do you get the battery out? There's no instructions in there either. That looks right. There's your on off button. Those are your fingers that move the balls along. Drop it down in there. There's your battery. Don't lose that fucking strap, you'll be screwed. Guess it just clicks back in like that. And I'm gonna lift that forward. There you go. Make sure she's nice and tight. Now, putting it back together one-handed is a little tricky. But what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pause the video and I'm gonna come back with the gun completely assembled. Okay, so we are back. And yes, just to confirm, the battery is in the foregrip of the gun. I thought that, I just didn't know for sure. The grips seem pretty robust, but they also do leave the open feeling of the plastic here, which I wasn't aware of. That being said, the hopper seems extremely robust to opening. Let's see if I can balance it here. So, basically you have to push in on the lid and pull up. If you just go to push up, you're going to be pushing really hard. I don't know if you can see my finger changing color. But then it's just as simple as that. It comes up. This seems like a pretty solid clip. I will report back if there's any issues as far as this goes. I will make more videos of actually going paintballing as well. Because I feel like this is something that is going to be a pretty cool hobby for me. I'm going to call it, can't call it Killer Bee, can I? Or Stinging Bee. I'm going to call it the Stinging Bee, because it's going to hurt. And I'm going to get hurt. That's part of the game. But paintball doesn't really, really hurt as far as guns go. But anyway, I appreciate your guys' time. This is my unboxing. You will get a video of me firing it, but I just need balls, which I have at my cousin's house, and I already have a filled up cylinder, and my barrel squeegee. I'm ready to go. So I got my mask in the car and got to upgrade from getting slush pants to a little bit better things. Thanks for your time, guys. Have fun. Be safe.